The night was bright, and I had consumed a few adult beverages. I had nothing to worry about, but they told me to stay on the road, but I was young and foolish, and I thought, why would anyone want to stay on the road on a night like tonight? I mean, I knew the way, so I used the shortcut on this narrow trail, which had never been a problem. Anyway, I heard a noise and fell on the ground. Not unusual for my condition, so I righted myself to find my way home, and upon my attempt to crawl into bed, I noticed a tear in my trousers, and below that tear was a scratch, just a small wound that would change my life forever. When the moon was full, I grew ill. I had a fever and a rash. Nothing to complicate my life. All right, yeah, these things happen. But as the second cycle of the moon started, I noticed some concerns. My skin began to itch, and my teeth felt as if they needed to be ripped from my mouth. My fingernails burned like a match head. As I made my way to the hospital, I woke without my clothes in an alley with no explanation. Sorry to say that also not that unusual for the kind of kid that I was. Okay, I admit it. So, wrapping old newspapers around my body, I made my way home. The third moon rose, and that's when I knew I had problems. Being aware of my approaching sickness, I attempted to lock myself into my house. Yeah. Silly to think that a small door lock could contain my need for the night, because it was this night that I learned of my love for the hunt. My only memory of this night was chasing small animals, and the delight of hearing their bones cracking in my jaws. I felt this quite satisfying until I awoke with my neighbor's cat's flesh in my mouth. as I fixed the door frame in my house, I grew afraid of what I had become. Not knowing who or what I am, how could I control myself? The next moon was only a couple of weeks away. I decided sedation was the only answer. Sleep this one off. But as the next moon rose, a handful of pills was no match for the coat of fur I would wear that night. I woke in my living room and thought maybe the night in the town went without loss of life. I mean, there was no blood on me, no claw marks, no raw flesh in my palate. And then I heard the news. A small boy had been disemboweled in the city park. I began to cry. This was my low point. After several suicide attempts, by the way, that silver bullet thing doesn't work. I found myself at the zoo, watching the wolves. I met the handler for the wolf exhibit, and I explained my situation to him, feeling that I had nothing to lose. Son of a gun, for a nominal fee, I have found myself a relaxing place to spend my moonlit nights. Yeah, it costs a little extra for him to throw in a small goat or a sheep, but I find it's worth it. Makes me wonder how many other evening clients